Welcome back to the channel, RPA Champions. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you 5 ways that are going to make you into a power user on ChatGPT. What does that mean? That means that the output that ChatGPT produces for you is going to be of much greater content. And also, the time that it takes you to talk with ChatGPT and go through conversations and insert examples and information, it is going to be much less than what it is today. Many people have the question of what happens with the information that I sent to ChatGPT. Now that information, if you go inside of the settings of ChatGPT and you go into the data controls, if you uncheck this setting right here, your information is not going to be sent to ChatGPT for training on other models. So if you value your privacy or you don't want to share your data, you would want to uncheck this checkbox right here and click on done. Second tip that you should do when using ChatGPT is still in the settings. You should go into the personalization. Now, often people say that the output that ChatGPT provides is not really tailored to the way that they write or to the way that they express themselves or that they would write something. They stop using it. However, you can change this with ChatGPT. There are 2 features that you can use to customize this. The custom instructions. Once you click on the custom instructions, you are going to have 2 checkboxes or 2 input fields. In these 2 input fields, in the first one, you are going to answer something like, what would you like ChatGPT to know about you to provide better responses? And in the other one would be, how would you like ChatGPT to respond? So in the first one, you would answer things like, what is your name? What is your occupation? What kind of things you do, you like? What are your hobbies? And things like that. So that it gets a context and it knows to what kind of work you're doing so that it can talk in that tone or that context. It knows what kind of hobbies and stuff like that so that it can consider that in the way that it writes its responses. In the other side is how would you like ChatGPT to respond? Here you can be more specific and guide the style and the format in a much more direct way. For example, I would like it to respond always in a casual, friendly manner, using a vocabulary of a 10-year-old or something similar like that. Now, by setting these 2 things, you're going to save yourself a lot of time in rewriting and redoing the responses that ChatGPT creates for you. The next thing is this memory option right here that you can disable or enable however you like. This memory option right here, it is going to allow ChatGPT to store memory of snippets during a conversation. Let's see an example of how this would work. So if I were to write here something like, my name is Gregor, remember it. So we can see here that memory has been updated and we can go inside of the memories and we can see that there is name is Gregor. So it's going to remember that my name is Gregor so that I don't have to use it afterwards in other conversations. So let's say I open another ChatGPT and I ask it, what is my name? It is going to tell me that my name is Gregor because it remembers that from previous context that was inserted into memory. Now, this is a great feature. Sometimes ChatGPT is going to automatically insert things into memory. Sometimes you're going to have to tell it what kind of things you wanted to insert into memory if specific things need to be inside of memory. Now, for tip number 3, ChatGPT or OpenAI releases different kinds of models very often. And in the past few months, they have released quite a few models in a very short amount of time. These models have some great features. They are very different from one from another. So I highly recommend that you often, when using ChatGPT, you select the model that you want to work with. Right now, ChatGPT 4.0 with Canva has been released and it provides some great features, some really nice time-saving features that I really want to show you. So let's say we wanted to build a HTML game. So I asked to build me a HTML game. It is going to open a Canva very similar to what Claude has, if you have used Claude. However, this has even more features than Claude has. Now, once it has finished compiling all of the code here, in the right side of the window in the bottom, we're going to see a couple of icons that are going to be generated randomly based on the content that I have here. So here I have code. So these are going to be code review, going to be add comments, add logs, fix bugs, port to another language, and so forth. However, if I had text in here, these buttons would be something different. Now, why is this such a great feature? Because it allows you to iterate over what it has produced initially without waiting or without having it to produce different things. And you can also go and interact with different sections of this code. However, let's first see these buttons that were created for us right here. Now, once I click, for example, on add comments, and then I confirm the insertion, we can see that the AI is going to go through all of this code line by line and insert the content or the comments wherever it requires the comments to be inserted. If I wanted to say, for example, like change a function like this, I could click right here and add some debugging to this. Ask it to add some debugging to this, so it's going to leave all of the code as what it was and add some debugging to this feature right here, saving me loads of time. Let's see one more quick example. So write me a LinkedIn post. It has created a LinkedIn post, and here we can see that the buttons are different. We can add emojis, we can add comments as well. So let's see now that it's add some emojis. We can add the final finishing polish, change the reading level, so make it more graduate school or more kindergarten. Let's leave it as kindergarten, and we can see it being rephrased. And add also the final finishing touches, and my post is going to be created. Catch the ball, I just made a simple game called catch the ball, etc. And also here I can click on different parts such as this, and I can ask the AI to change this content right here. So for example, make this with no emojis. And that is going to remove all of the emojis, obviously, just from this part right here. So for my tip number four, I highly suggest that before using ChatGPT for whatever you need to do, try to pick the right model for the right use case that you are working on. And for tip number five, don't just use ChatGPT all the time with the different models. You also can explore all kinds of different GPTs that are specially designed and created for certain things. Therefore, this feature is completely free. You can, even as a free user, you can search for different GPTs that are specific in certain topics and use those GPTs. For example, let's say I wanted to create a crew AI agent. So here we, for example, we have different crew AI flows or assistants that have been specialized on building crew AIs. And for this, we can also have YouTube, we have a search engine optimization, we have all kinds of different GPTs. This is going to allow you to save loads of time of telling ChatGPT what it should do specifically, inserting your own prompts, and potentially wasting time to do that. So if you find a good chat here, there is plenty. There's many different chats and many are really bad, but you can judge by the number of users that talk with it how good this conversation has been. So this one, Scholar GPT, has had 2 million conversations with a rating of 4.2. I would definitely give it a try if this is the need of a use case that I needed to solve. So that's it, RPA champions. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. I'm using ChatGPT in many different kinds of automations to create content, to summarize things, also via APIs. If you're interested in seeing different kinds of automations, leave a comment down below. Don't forget to leave me a thumbs up for this video if you have enjoyed it. Have a great day, and I will see you in the next automation video.